I think a lot of people who follow Bad Bunny's music was waiting for that moment too. Hola amor, I'm Feid, I'm El Fercho, and I'm gonna be reacting to some of my most iconic moments in my life or my career. So, mama, hey, let's go. I wasn't expecting this kind of moment. That's so fun. Okay, so this video is so special because we record this in Infinity Music. It was like my first studio, like my first house for like kind of way. It's not where I used to live, but it was like Sky's studio. And it was just one day, like Mosty bought a new camera and he told me like, hey, let's make a video of this song that you're gonna drop. And I was like, okay. And we just put the camera on and start recording all around the building. And we have this video with this song that went so big, like went so big in Costa Rica back at those days, you know, but it was so cool. I was like eating a lot of burgers at that time. That's nice. Now I don't know what's the most viewed video on my YouTube, but I can tell you that having 2 million back on those days was like my goal, you know? Like just having 1 million for me was like crazy. I'm so excited for the next one. I love this one too, because this one is so special because I record this video the day before my birthday. There's something happening every year around my birthday. It was Que Raro, the song with J Balvin. It was like my first song that I like dropped with Universal Music and all that stuff. And so for me it was like a crazy day, a crazy birthday. And it was a long time ago, I think like 5 years, 7 years, 6 years, I don't know, 7 years? Okay, crazy. 7 years ago, we did this song, Que Raro, Feid y J Balvin. That's crazy. He let people know that there's somebody from Colombia that is about to kill, we don't know when, but he's doing like a good job, he's doing good songs. And it was the part of a successful career of like a lot of things that I started like doing in the studio, like understanding myself as an artist and some other things that makes me like explode. But this one specifically, it was like a song that I was really like with a lot of faith on it. Like this is gonna make me like do something really cool. And it was, you know? That moment is like an epic moment, pal Fercho, pal Feid. I remember a lot of Bad Bunny's like first song because the first song that I heard about Bad Bunny was released the same day that I released our last like memory, the Que Raro. So the day that I dropped Que Raro, he dropped like his first song, I guess. I don't know if it was his first song, but it was the first song that I heard from Bad Bunny. And I remember that I think like, oh, this guy is so good. And then he started dropping another one and then another one. And then he started like growing and growing and growing and doing a lot of good things. And I have a lot of respect for him and for the way that he like treat the art that he put out for the people. So for me it was like a moment, like a huge, it was like one of my like epic moments in my career because my fans like a lot of years was waiting for this moment. I think a lot of people who follow Bad Bunny's music was waiting for that moment too. And that day in the studio and that day in the Choliseo de Puerto Rico when he dropped the song was crazy. Like all the Choli went to green because of my color and all that stuff. So it was so nice. Yeah, so you scared, that's crazy. When we were in the studio, he told me that like he told me everything that he was about to do, you know, like he told me like, I'm gonna do this trap album. I'm gonna do like a lot of trap songs. And when your song comes, people are gonna be like crazy because they are not expecting this. So it's the only reggaeton on the album. And I was like, bro, really? You're giving me that spot? And he was like, yeah, you're doing a good job on reggaeton. And I think this gonna like break all markets and everything. And that's what happened. So for me, it's like so cool, you know? I can't like find any English word. En español, yo diría que me siento una rechimba, like I feel like rechimba, but I can't find like any word that describes that word, that feeling, you know? Beautiful. That was a huge moment for me too, because I'm a real fan of Rema music, you know? I went to a lot of other shows in Miami, in when we recorded this song, I went to Canada to watch him like performing live. And then we went to the studio next day to finish the lyrics and helping him with his Espanol and all that stuff. This video was so crazy because I fly from Los Angeles to Nueva York and then to Madrid to record this video one day, like 20 hours or 18 hours. We record that and then we fly back to Miami. I guess Nueva York, then Miami. I can't even remember, but we took like 6 flights to get there and work on this video. So I think that's why it's so special, that moment, having Rema on it. Rema is a super like huge artist for a lot of people, for a lot of countries, you know? So I feel like so, como blessed, you know, to having him on a video and kicking with him and just talking with him as a friend, you know, that's so nice. Oh, it hurts a lot. I had a long scar here in my leg, but it was okay. It was like kind of something that I'm really cool with, you know? I love to have like you know this thing and still performing, and I was with blood on my legs and I was still like singing and running and having fun with the people. And then after the show, people come to me and do like I don't know how to say that in English, como que me coció, you know? They put like some hilo on it to stop like the bleeding and all that stuff. But it was so fun. I feel like a skater or something, just having fun, you know? It was so nice. I mean, like, it hurts a lot. After the show, during the show, it wasn't like any pain, nothing. The next day, I have a lot of pain on my leg, but that's something that happens, you know? I remember the face of the people in the front of the crowd was like, oh, because I started like bleeding. But I look at my leg and I didn't saw nothing because I was like so hype and so hot, you know, like running, sweating. So people were like, oh, with the cell phone, like just recording my leg and all that stuff. And they were like not impatient when the people was like treating me. So they wait like for 5 or 10 minutes. Like so quiet, and they start screaming Fercho, and that's like so important because when you have like silence on your concerts, that's like, whoa, man, there's something bad happening. And they were like so chill, like, oh, what's happened with Fercho? And when I came out again, they were like, ah! They went super crazy. The show was like even better, like the energy was like 200% up. So I really want to say thank you for that to all my Madrid fans, for other people who went to Wizzing Center at that moment. That I mean, like, I have that on my skin right now, so that's so nice. Bueno, amor, thank you for watching me reacting to my best memories, my most iconic moments. I don't know, there's a lot of cool videos right here, so go stream an album, Mor No Le Temas A La Oscuridad, go hear Boogaloo, whatever you want to do with Fercho Music. Muchas gracias, amor, let's go.